Hello friends, good morning. We have completed some topics yesterday and I hope you all have got. If you have in doubt, you can personally contact me, okay? And we have started last day, physical quality of life. This topic I have started. I hope you all have understood because of minor change in the physical quality of life and physical quality of life index. Okay, what do you mean by the physical quality of life and this all aspects which we have completed yesterday? These all have 10 aspects. Okay, these 10 aspects we have completed yesterday, and then now we are going to start our next topic, that is the physical quality of life index. What do you mean by the physical quality of life index? Physical quality of life index, that means which can be measured the economic development with the help of the physical quality of life. Physical quality of life, that means what? By which level that quality of a standard of a person is improving. That is the physical quality of life index. Okay. Actually, its short name is PQLI. Physical quality of life index. Index. Index, that means which will be measured by the 100%. Clear? Second one thing is the economic development which has done, which we will be measured by these three aspects. But before that, who has given this and what is its use and how it can be used? These all questions maybe you have in mind. First of all, I will clear this all. Then I will start in detail that this one. Okay. Physical quality of life index, which is explaining its meaning by the name only. Physical quality of life index is related to economic development, which can be measured the economic development. Okay, because of all other indicators have their own limitations. Economic growth rate of economic country's growth rate. Okay, and second one which we have completed, per capita income related, growth rate of per capita income. That one also we have completed, and now third one is the physical quality of life index. Last which we have completed 2 years yesterday. Before that, these all have also limitations. Okay, may I correct? And someone which we have completed now in the per capita income related as an indicator, we see in so many limitations we are there. In growth rate of financial income also have some limitations. So now we are discussing the next topic, that is the PQLI. What do you mean by the PQLI? PQLI is an index. Okay. PQLI also will discuss about an index. An index, that means what? 100 by 100 we will measure it. PQLI has given by first time Morris Davis Morris in the 1917, he has given this overseas development, and he has given in the Overseas Development Council. Okay, in 1917, Morris Davis Morris, you remember this, because of this idea has given by Morris Davis Morris in the 1970 in the Overseas Development Council. Okay, and now at present UNDP also has accepted this. And at present, it is related to three aspects. Okay, physical quality of life index is related to three aspects. By these three aspects, we can measure. And it will be measured by the betterment of the quality of the life. Betterment of the quality of life, that means what? How that peoples are improving their life standard. By that, we will be measuring it. Okay, these three standards. First one, this one has given by the Morris Davis Morris. This idea has given by the Morris Davis Morris. You can write in 1970 in the Overseas Development Council. Okay. And physical quality of life determines the level of economic development. Okay. By this level, we will determine the level of economic development, by which level a country is developing. Okay. If the country's physical quality of life index is higher, then we will say that country is higher developing country. Then that country is considered as more developed country. If we are going to compare, suppose India, Pakistan, China, Nepal, Bhutan, these all countries, if we are measuring, if one country's physical quality of life index is high, then we will say that country is higher developing country compared to all others. Okay. Two countries, more than two countries, can be compared to each other with the help of the physical quality of life. 8% UNDP also using this one. Now, this next physical quality of life, these are three factors. There's three determinants, you can see. And for three mark question, if the question is what do you mean by the physical quality of life index, write in detail. Then for 3 marks, you have to write that meaning. Who has presented this? You will write Morris. Davis Morris has presented in 1970 in the Overseas Development Council. He has given this idea, and according to physical quality of life index, it will be determined the level of the country's economic development. Okay, it will be measured by these three determinants. These three determinants will measure the country's people's life standard. What is their life standard? If their life standard is good, then it will, its percentage will be high. If it is low, then its percentage will be low. And its measuring value is 0 to 100. You can write it. Its measuring value is 0 to 100. After that, you can write. You have to write point wise this answer so you can easily learn. You start from the Morris Davis Morris, then meaning, then its measuring value. Its measuring value is 0 to 100. It has three aspects. There's three standards, measures, and three aspects are extent of education. First, second one, life expectancy. Third one, infant mortality rate. Okay, these are three. First one, extent of the education. Extent of education, that means what? Literacy level of a country. What is it still be measured? It will be measured the literacy level of country. What is the situation of the education in the country? It will be measured this one only. Okay, then how we will be measured? From here you learn the percentage of population. The percentage of population educated out of total population. Out of total population determines the extent of education. Very simple. What do you mean by the extent of education in the PQLI? The percentage of population educated out of total population. It's just measure the literacy level of the country. Second one. What do you mean by the life expectancy? Life expectancy, that means if a country's peoples will live how many years, that is the life expectancy. You can say number of years a child is expected to live at the time of birth. At the time of birth, it's known as life expectancy. Number of years a child is expected to live at the time of birth, that is known as life expectancy. If a country's life expectancy is high, then what will you say? You will say that country is high developed country, correct? If a country's life expectancy is very low, then we will say that country is low developing country. That means we can easily measure, but not only by any one single determinants. We will be measure this all three determinants with each other. Then after we will be measure the PQLI. Method of PQLI I will discuss in the next. Now we will discuss about what is the PQLI. How many determinants and how it will be measured. I will discuss in the next lecture. Okay, now at present I'm just discussing it. What do you mean by the PQLI? PQLI, that means what? Physical quality of life index, okay, which has presented by Morris Davis Morris in 1970 in the overseas development council, okay, and he has given his idea about Morris Davis Morris has given idea about the PQLI. And physical quality of life index is a type of index, and in this we will can be measure a country's economic development with the help of three determinants. And these three determinants are extent of education, life expectancy, infant mortality rate. These three will be measured with the help of these all three. We can be measure the PQLI, and then after its value we will be measure that, well, this value is the 0 to 100. If a country is close to zero, then we can say that country is a low developing country. If country's index will close to 100, then we will say high developing country. And that value we can be measured with the help of these three indicators, these three determinants. Okay, these three determinants are PQLI related. Three determinants are extent of education, life expectancy, infant mortality rate. Life extent of education, that means what? Literacy level of a country. Literacy level of a country will be measured. That means the percentage of population educated out of total population. Okay. Next one is the life expectancy. What do you mean by the life expectancy? Life expectancy, that means how many years a child will live. Okay, that is just expectation. Not actual. If I will say our India's life expectancy is 62 years, that means no one will die before 62. Okay. And no one will die after 62. No, it's just expectations. Okay. Which we can be expect, which we can, or a country can be expect with the help of the health and medical facilities. Clear? So life expectancy, that means what? Number of years a child is expected to live at the time of birth. It's known as life expectancy. It shows the average life. Remember this. It just shows the average life, not actual life. If life expectancy rise, it can be said that the medical services of a country is good. That medical services and availability of hospitals, availability of doctors, all are sufficient. Okay. Then life expectancy will be high. Next one is the infant mortality rate. What do you mean by the infant mortality rate? Infant mortality rate, that means the number of infant, that means what? Newborn baby, you know, just you can say that is only 0 to 1 year, like this. Okay, that is known as infant, 0 to 1 year. If a baby's age is 0 to 1, that is known as infant. Clear? So the number of infant who die out of every 1,000 infants before completing their 1 year, or you can say first year, it is known as infant mortality rate. Clear? I will repeat again. The number of infants who die out of every 1,000 infants before completing their first year, that is known as infant mortality rate. Okay? And if infant mortality rate falls, that means that countries, all type of availability of hospitals, medical services, availability of the doctors are good and they are carrying good health services. So that country will improve their economic level. So I have done this all three aspects. I hope you all have got these three aspects. Clear? From beginning to next. What do you mean by the physical? Remind again. What do you mean by the physical quality of life index? Okay, we will start from the points. We will write this point. Maurice Davis Maurice has given this idea, physical quality of life index, in the Overseas Development Council, okay, in 1970. And he has given this idea just like an index. This index will measure the value from 0 to 100. If a country is a low developing country, then that will be close to zero. If a country is high developing country, then it will be close to 100. Physical quality of life index determines the level of economic development. Okay. Because if a country will be improve their level, economic level, then that country's physical quality of life index will also improve, because they will use good standard of living. They will use a good and better quality goods. Clear? If any country's physical quality of life index will be high, that means that country is high developing country. If that any country's physical quality of life index will low, that means that country is low developing country. It has as three determinants or three aspects or three factors. The three factors are extent of education, life expectancy, and infant mortality rate. Okay. And extent of education means, that means what? Literacy level of a country. How we can measure the percentage of population educated out of total population, that is extent of education. Second one is life expectancy. What do you mean by the life expectancy? Life expectancy, that means Number of years a child is expected to live at the time of birth. That means it is just an average, not actual life. Clear? If a country's life expectancy is high, that means that country has good medical services, good health services, good availability of the hospitals, availability of doctors are sufficient. So that country's life expectancy is high, and then we will say that country is high developing country. But not only by this, we will be measured this all three overall, then after we will say according to PQRL. Okay. Infant mortality rate. Infant, that means what? Newborn baby whose age is 0 to 1 year. That is known as infant. Clear this word? Infant mortality rate. Infant mortality rate will measure by this. The number of infants who die out of every 1,000 infants before completing their first year. It's known as infant mortality rate. If infant mortality rate falls, that means that country said the health services and other care services are good in a country. Clear? So PQRL, that means it is the combination of this all three. These three are literacy level. Second one is what? Second one is known as life expectancy. Third one is infant mortality index or rate. Okay, there's all three. Reasons for only these three determinants. Why only these three determinants we have added in the PQL? Because of first one reason. Dependable data for all these factors can be required for all the countries. Because of this dependable data for all these factors can be acquired for all the countries. We are just thinking if there's all three data are acquired for all the countries. Second one, what is the reason? Second one reason is that all these three factors, that means there's infant mortality rate, life expectancy, and education related. So all these three factors, or you can say determinants, depicts the result, not offers. They will show, they will depict the result, not offers. So we are saying that it is the reason to select these all three determinants. Last one, all these three factors are product based. These all three factors are product based and hence fulfill the justifiable standard for the performance comparison. So they will be justified the standard for the performance of the comparison between two countries and more than two countries. Okay, there's all three are literacy. This is a very important measure road for the physical quality of life, increasing in the literacy, and the education shows rise in the welfare of the individual. Human efficiency is a necessary aspect for the national development. Second one is life expectancy. Increase in the life expectancy is a mirror of the social environment. If social environment is good, then life expectancy will be good. Okay, not only this, nutrition, medical services, medical care, environmental situations, this all will be also included here. Infant mortality rate, it is a reflection of social status of welfare. It will be reflect what is the social status of the welfare. Okay, so we can be easily measure this. What is the social status for and welfare? Okay, so first one, life expectancy is the mirror of the social environment. Okay, and well-being, only for that reason it we have selected. And it is very important measuring role for the physical quality of life, like literacy level. If education is there, then we can say human efficiency. So this all three only, there's only three aspects have selected for that, because of the first one will indicate the human efficiency, second will be indicate the social environment and well-being, third will be just reflect to the social status of and welfare. So all three aspects we have selected, or Morris has selected for the PQLI. Okay, formulation of PQLI we will discuss tomorrow. I hope you all have got, and if you have any doubt, any type of query, please personally message. Okay, thank you. We will meet again in the next lecture, in the next period. You complete your assignment, whatever assignment I had given, please complete this all. Thank you very much. Okay.